So,
when you are ready, you tell me and we begin.
Okay. Okay, I'm ready.
Okay, good. So, what was the origin of this project?
The origin of this project was, I had a dream.
Yes.
12 years ago.
Okay.
Like a dream from sleeping. Okay. You know, not like a dream, like a vision of a greater future, but a dream from sleeping. And I woke up and I grabbed a pen and a piece of paper and I wrote down, the eyes of the deceased come back in newborns.
Okay.
And I didn't know what it meant. I just had to write it down. And 12 years later, I met Michael Pitt in a coffee shop in New York.
Okay.
You saw that fly. It's in my eye. Okay, the fly was trying to say something. You see?
Yes.
So now flies have really specific eyes.
Yes.
And they're very different from human eyes.
Okay.
They have multiple lenses.
Yes.
Correct. And yet, and we are very different from humans. We're very different from flies. And yet, flies and humans have the exact same gene.
Yes, of
course. PAX6, which creates an eye.
Okay.
So I was obsessed with the eyes.
Okay.
That's the origin.
After seeing your five movie. Science take after in another Earth an important place to in this story. Do you believe that all can be explained through science?
I think not everything can be explained through science. Love cannot be explained through science.
Okay, good. High origin is based on of the work of John Dogman. How did you take in consideration his work?
He proposed the theory, John Dogman proposed the theory that all eyes are unique like a fingerprint.
Yes.
And if all eyes are unique like a fingerprint, we should look very closely at our lovers and our loved ones and our families' eyes, because they are this unique, beautiful work of art that is theirs.
Okay. Can you talk about your long collaboration with Brett Marling?
Yes. Brett Marling and I met at Georgetown and we became very close friends. We've collaborated on short films when we were students. We collaborated on documentaries, and then we collaborated on fiction films together. She's someone I trust more than anybody. She's brilliantly talented. I'm lucky to have her in my life. And she's just, yeah.
Okay. Why did you choose to take your inspiration to create the Ian Gray character from the scientist Richard Dawkins?
Why did you take your... can I read the question?
Yes, okay.
Why did you choose to take inspiration from create the Ian Gray character from the scientist Richard Dawkins? Great question.
Thank you.
Richard Dawkins is one of the leading atheistic science evolutionary biologists today.
Okay.
He's a very, very interesting guy, and we thought his point of view, if transforming someone with that point of view to a character who has faith,
okay,
would be a really interesting challenge.
Astrid Burgess Frisbee as Sophie is a perfect choice.
Oh, thank you very much.
Yes, I like her. How did you choose her and how did you know about her?
Michael Pitt told me about her.
Yes.
And then I watched a couple films of hers and then I Skyped with her and I realized that she was brilliant and I wanted to work with her right away.
Good.
From the moment I met her.
Good. Can you talk also of your collaboration with Michael Pitt? What did you bring to his character?
Michael Pitt created his character from the ground up. He is one of the most hardworking, talented artists of this generation. And I love him as a human being. He's such a great guy. He has a wonderful sense of humor. He has honesty and authenticity in his performance that's both surprising and honest. And for me, I think that's just absolutely exciting to see on screen.
Perfect. Yesterday, in the press conference, you said that you like to speak with scientists.
Yes.
You said that one of your brother yesterday is a molecular biologist.
Yes.
How does he see your movie from a scientist point of view?
Has he seen the movie?
Yes.
Yes. And he likes it.
Yes.
He says, we did a very good job at capturing the spirit of a young PhD student whose number one priority is discovery and advancing knowledge. So I feel really proud about that.
Yes. Did you see Minority Report? Can you tell me if this movie has been an inspiration for you? Which movie has been a source of inspiration?
I have seen Minority Report.
Because the eyes.
Yeah. It's a great movie. I like it. Minority Report is the only movie. Here's a little detail. Minority Report is the only movie that I own on Blu-ray.
Yes.
I don't know why, but it is the only movie that I own on Blu-ray. Because I have a DVD collection, and then I have a lot of things, digital versions. But I have one Blu-ray, and it is Minority Report. And in Minority Report, yes. They have the iris scanning. Yeah.
Yes.
So that's, you know, Spielberg did a great deal of research about what the future will be like for that movie, which is really incredible. And so that was inspirational, certainly, I guess. And let's just say that.
Okay, perfect. Which difficulties did you meet during the shooting in New Delhi?
In where?
New Delhi.
In New Delhi.
Yes,
New Delhi.
India.
What difficulties did we in filming in New Delhi?
Yes.
We worked with an incredible team in New Delhi that made shooting very smooth, actually. They have a wonderful, huge film industry in India, obviously Bollywood, which internally in the country of India is very, very successful. It's a billion, trillion almost dollar industry. So they, you know, some of the greatest film artists live in India. And so I worked with this incredible Steadicam operator, for example, who could walk on a tightrope doing, you know, juggling and operating a Steadicam at the same time. So we didn't have that many problems in India. It was actually a smooth shoot.
Okay. And my next question, what are your current projects?
My current projects are and another one that's
jeter?
Yes!
Jeter.
La Jeter.
La Jeter.
La Jeter is a great film, by the way.
Yes, did you see the short movie?
Yes, I've seen
because
the short
movie. Because I think it's 12 Monkeys.
Is based on it. That's a great movie, too.
Yes.
I love both of those movies.
Good. Thank you very much for this interview.
Thank you, Boris. It was such
a
pleasure.
Have a good day.
I really enjoyed it.
Thank you.
You made it so much fun. Thank you.